Hey, thanks for tuning in. This is my third Sims 4 speed build, and I'm building in Willow Creek in the very wide plot. I think originally in the game it's the plot that has the gardens to grow plants in, and I think it's the is it best friends family? I don't remember what they're called, but one of those single young default sim families. Okay, so I had to look it up. It was the BFF family. I knew that would have just driven me crazy for the entire recording, so I took the time to look it up. So in this build, I wanted to do a duplex or townhome. At least that's what they're called where I live. I've also read that this type of home is called a twin home. Basically, this home is actually two houses, but they're butted up against each other with one shared wall, and the floor plans are identical, just reversed. I thought it would be kind of fun and a nice quick build that I could do. But as I was building, I came to realize that I was actually building two houses, and that means I had to decorate two houses, and that was just way too much for me to take on. So I ended up only decorating the left side, the left house, and while I put flooring and plain wallpaper and counters in the right side, I did not decorate it at all. But I figured it would be kind of cool to upload it to the gallery, and then whoever decides to download it, maybe they feel inspired to decorate the right side of the home how they want to do it. You know, sometimes it's fun to have an empty space and just fill it how you want to fill it, not what I do and the same things that I put in all the time. So yeah, speaking of me doing the same things over and over, I made garage doors exactly the way I do it. I use the same wallpaper with the panels and the same rectangular windows. One day I'll change. One day I'll get creative. Right now I'm adding the windows. I wanted to put shutters, and I really, really wanted to put brick on the home. I love brick houses. I think they're really nice. I must love brick so much that I made the driveway brick too. So I'm going through my process of putting in the flooring and putting up plain wallpaper so that in case I miss a spot that some of the walls are done, also place in all of the lights where I want them in the room so that they're centered. Kind of wanted this to have a slightly more country feeling, not so modern or contemporary, but I'm not really educated in design and the history of design, so I could be completely wrong in what, you know, what I actually did versus what I wanted it to be. It might be completely wrong, but instead of like the very, very clean lines, I chose to go for like the tiled counters and the wood paneled cabinets. And I see all the time on like those design TV shows that they like to mismatch the cabinets with the island, and so I thought I'd try that out. I think it looks pretty good. And I'm kind of a sucker for white countertops. I'm not a true fan of tiled counters, but I do like white. I think, you know, with my issues of being able to clean surfaces, I think grout is just a little too challenging for me. But I sort of realized at this point that I had the wrong height of the first floor. It was on the second highest ceiling height, and that was too high. I think that's why the garage looked a little strange and why the kitchen cabinets were just way too high. So I finally figured it out and adjusted the height and went back and fixed the kitchen and fixed the garage door. And with the dining table, like, I always have the hardest time picking what kind of chairs to go with the table, because my personal preference is to have clean lines, and I don't know, I mean, if I want it to look country-ish, then I shouldn't put a sleek dining chair, right? So, I don't know. Maybe you could help me out and tell me what I should be doing to achieve what I'm trying to achieve. Like, what kind of chairs would you have picked? Oh, and on that note, I believe I tried to keep the decorations I picked to the base game with no items from expansions, no custom content. So I hope that helps anyone out who may want to download it, and you know, they might not have the expansion, because I'm like that, where I don't buy every expansion because, you know, I'm not well off enough to just buy everything that comes out. But yeah, I'm the type that, you know, when I played Sims 3, like, I would have to like check. I think I would save it, and then something would happen where we would delete the game, and then the expansions were installed, so when I had saved some homes, like, the game would put in decorations for you to replace the other decoration, and it would always come out looking hideous. So I'm hoping to avoid that by using base game items only. Like, I never tried downloading something that I didn't have the expansion for, so I'm not sure what would happen in Sims 4. So I'm working on the master bathroom with the double sinks and the large bathtub. And I try to use the wall the wallpaper that used the really thick crown molding, because I think that's really pretty. I've recently become a huge fan of crown molding and trim. I think that's the first time I ever put a hamper in Sims 4. I tried really hard in this particular build to create a little more clutter. That's really not my forte. I mean, I can really appreciate people who can design Sims homes to look lived in and it looks well decorated as well. Like, I have this really set mind to always center things, always put like how this room is, where the bed is in between the two windows and it's situated straight. Like, I never angle the beds, or like once in a while angle like that lamp, or because it just looks so static, I guess, like too perfect when it's straight, but which is kind of funny because everything else is very straight. So yeah, I tried to put things out, fill up corners, and you know, like not put everything so even. But I guess the overall color scheme of this house is I used some yellows and golds and blue. Shades of blue. Ooh, I love that. I really love that really dark navy blue with the white trim and the dark wood floors. Like, I think that's so nice. Really rich looking. And funny enough too, like, I tend to do the bedrooms last, which makes it like the worst rooms that I ever do, because by that point I'm tired and I just throw things anywhere. But I consciously made an effort to do the master bedroom after the kitchen and dining room so that I could put more care into the decorating of it. So I guess the room that suffered in this build was the living room. was just a lot of space to fill, and I thought maybe putting bookshelves would fill up the space and kind of give warmth. And things like the cookie jars and the utensil holders, like, those are things that I just don't really put out. Like, I just don't think to put them out, and I really tried hard to put these kind of things in this home. I never know where to put those screens. They're so huge and they bend in a really hard angle to place them near a wall. So I put like a chair by the front door, like little things to show that, you know, if somebody wanted to put their shoes on to leave, that they could sit there and put their shoes on. I mean, more realistic life type of things versus, you know, perfect decorations. A townhome, you know, where there's like a little patio out in the back with no real lawn or backyard to take care of, but just have a nice little place to barbecue. Moving on to the landscaping. I really mixed things up this time. I think normally I do it around the same time I do the exterior of the house. Putting plants between the driveways to kind of give the home some feel of separation. Wasn't quite sure what to do with the yard. Like, I just wanted flowers and trees, but it's not easy. Not a lot of times, like, I'll just throw around dirt patches here and there to kind of give variation in the lawn so that it doesn't look so perfect. I'm surprised that those flowers are in the base game. I actually thought that they came with the outdoor retreat. So now I'm working on matching the left house since I had altered quite a bit. And I was having problems with those rectangular windows. They didn't want to stay right where I would let go. Like, it kept snapping up to like a really small space, but it still looked like it was crooked. That didn't sit well with me. So now it's just all about putting in the windows, putting in the doors and lights with matching up the floor plan. I tried to make the front yard a little bit different on the right side. I didn't want it to be like so symmetrical. I just wanted beautiful flowers and trees. So I didn't put anything in, but I did put the kitchen counters because I'm just being a control freak, maybe. But I did change the kitchen island and I put the sink on the island instead of by the window. So there is something different. I don't know, I think I'm finding mistakes that I made. Which means I might have to go back in and fix them before I upload it to the gallery. But we're nearing the end. Here's the front, living room, kitchen, master bedroom, master bath, guest bath, and guest bedroom. I don't know, I hope you liked the video. See you next time.